యాయిదం
పరమగుహ్యం
మద్భక్తేషు అభిదాస్యతి భక్తిం మయి పరాం కృత్వా మామేవ ఏష్యతి అసంశయః. సో వాట్ ఇస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ శ్లోక? వి హ్యావ్ టు when we meet people, when we meet friends, we discuss something, right? What do we discuss normally with friends? What do you discuss?
About movies.
Movies.
Which movie we watched, which places we visited, cosmetics.
Cosmetics.
Dresses.
Dresses. So, here Shri Krishna says, Madbhakta means my devotees, those who are in satsanga. These are all people in satsanga. Okay? Satsanga means they are actually seeking divine guidance, seeking God. They're called satsanga. In satsanga, you should always discuss about how I can do service, how I can help each other. Okay? Everybody is suffering. So how I can remove suffering of ourselves or suffering of somebody? So that we should discuss. We should never be selfish, right? How I can help each other? How we can do service to others? How we can do service to animals? How we can do service to this thing? Everybody, how I can see Krishna in everybody? See God. God is in my heart, and God is in the heart of her. God is in the heart of you. God is in the heart of everybody. God is in the heart of the dog. God is in the heart of animals. God is in the heart of everywhere. So how I can help little bit somebody, this is what you have to discuss. Madbhakta means a group of people who are devotees or bhaktas of Krishna. We should not waste our time discussing on silly things. But don't start discussing this with your friends. Then the moment you come, they'll run away. This girl is only talking about service. I don't want service. I want a new movie. Right? So with the friends, you don't show all these things. Because those who are not interested, don't force them on that. But those who are interested in Bhagavad Gita, those who are interested in Krishna, discuss about only God. Okay? By discussing what will happen, so that's called Navada Bhakti. Shravanam,
Shravanam,
Kirtanam,
Kirtanam,
Smaranam,
Smaranam,
Harehe,
Harehe,
Padasevanam,
Padasevanam,
Vandanam,
Vandanam,
Dasyam,
Dasyam,
Sakhyam,
Sakhyam,
Atmanivedanam,
Atmanivedanam.
So we should help each other to get more bhakti, devotion. Okay, how I can help somebody should be our question rather than what somebody can do for me. We should drop selfishness. Now I'm not speaking of the other friends, okay? Other friends you don't talk about bhakti. But if your friends who are involved in Bhagavad Gita, how we can strengthen the bhakti of each other? Okay? How we can help each other? So tell something about Bhagavad Gita, tell something about Krishna, tell something about God. Okay, always think of God. That's first is called Shravana. Okay, we have to listen about God. Who will tell you about God? From Guru, I have to listen. Right? From the higher, I have to listen. And Shravanam Kirtanam means I have to tell it to somebody. Right? What I have listened, I have to tell. There is always somebody who knows less than me. There is always somebody who knows more than me. Okay, always, there is no point of time in a life when I have reached a perfection. Even whatever you know, there is always somebody who knows better than you. So when better than you is there, keep your mouth shut and listen. When somebody needs you, okay, then you become the guru, you become the representation of guru. Okay, whatever guru has told, you share with somebody so that that person will get some more light, help. So that's called kirtan. Listen when the opportunity is there, share when the opportunity is there. But don't share with somebody who are not bhaktas, who are not devotees, who don't believe in Bhagavad Gita. Don't do that. Because then they will start teasing you. Then they will start harassing you. Okay? Only with the bhaktas, devotees. Smaranam means whatever Guru has told, whatever Shri Krishna has told, remember. Whenever difficulties are there in your life, remember what God has said. Okay? Any situation in life, you will get some message in Bhagavad Gita. Everything in your life, get a message in Bhagavad Gita. A solution will come. Neither your father, neither your mother, nor your teacher can solve the problems. But Bhagavad Gita, Shri Krishna's message will solve the problems. How to solve the problems in life, you will get a message. Smaranam, remember, when you are in difficulty, remember the message of Bhagavad Gita. There was one person, he went to, in America, he was a mountaineer. He was going on a mountain. Going on the mountain, it was a snowfall. It's a Colorado mountain or something like that. There was a lot of snowfall and everything got cut off. Right? Now he has no way to come back. Then he found a cabin, wooden cabin, a small house where people where people used to live, but because of snowfall they have gone away. So he went there inside and he stayed there. There was snowfall which was almost 7 days. 7 days he didn't have food, nothing. But first, in that cabin, somebody had left a Bhagavad Gita book. He is American and he didn't have anything to do, time pass. So he started reading that. Then he got a lot of courage and confidence. He survived 7 days without food. Then he came back. He said, I survived because of Bhagavad Gita book. Because Bhagavad Gita gives a lot of confidence. If you read, understand the Bhagavad Gita message very clearly, it gives a lot of strength. Then he said, I'll share now. Okay? So I want to share this Bhagavad Gita with a lot of people in the world. Then he established a book trust called Bhakti Vedanta Book Trust of Prabhupada. So Bhakti Vedanta Book Trust is the number of books they have published, number of books they have sold all over the world is bigger than anything. It's like millions and millions and millions. So what happens is that when the boon comes from you, God boon from God comes to you, you have to share with somebody. Okay? But don't share with somebody who doesn't need it, doesn't like it. Share with your friend, share with your people. Tell story of Krishna, tell story of God. Tell story of meaning of Bhagavad Gita. Don't waste your time in discussing some silly things with people who are come to satsang. So then what will happen? Your boons will increase. Your grace will grace, more and more grace from Krishna will come. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Smaranam. Remember. Pada Sevanam. That means you offer your namaskaras to God. Be grateful. Doesn't mean that every day you go and do namaskara, namaskara. No. Be grateful to God. Okay? So we keep on complaining. I don't have this. I don't have this. How many complaints you have? Tell me in your life. Huh?
All the time complaining.
All the time complaining. I don't have this. I don't have this. I don't have this. Do you do like that? Huh?
No, we say the other also. I have problems. I have
worries. Yeah. So. Right? So, do you complain in your life? I don't have. How many times you have been grateful to God? So if you are grateful to God, then there's no complaint. Never there's a complaint in your life if their gratefulness is there. Why? Because God has given you so much. One lady was complaining to a Swamiji. God is, I don't know why God is not giving what I want, okay? I have a problem with my husband, I have a problem with children, God is so much of trouble for me, okay? I'm poor also, no money. Then Swami said, yeah, you don't have money. There is a way of getting money. Okay? Way of getting money. That's the easy way of money, getting money. Yeah, what is that easy way? I want. See, you can you donate one of your eyes? There is a person who wants eyes. He will give you 50,000 rupees. No, sorry. Yeah, I can't donate my eyes. See, there is a person who has no tongue. Okay? Give the tongue, you'll get 1 lakh rupees. No. There's a heart transplant possible. Somebody is not, doesn't have a heart, heart is trouble. You can give a heart, 5 lakh rupees. No. I don't want to give a heart. At least 1 kidney? Huh? Liver? No. So all these things are working fine. I don't want to give. See, you are already worth crores of rupees. So everything in you is part by part is working properly. Okay, everything is working for you, not because of you. That's the grace of God. Now, if such a beautiful machine which is working for you without any problem, why are you complaining? Why are you troubling? Why are you cribbing? Why have complaints? So, you are ignoring what you have and complaining what you don't have. Right? The moment you are thankful to God, that's called Vandana. Vandana means not just being Namaskara. Vandana means being thankful. God, because of your grace, everything is fine. No, there is a trouble coming. I am troubled. That's also the boon of God. That's also grace of God. Because the trouble makes you a better person. If there's no trouble, you'll be lazy. So everything is a gift from God. If you understand this, you will not have a single complaint in your life. If you have a single complaint in your life, that means you are not grateful to God. The complaints will go. Everything will be thankful and everything will be smiling. Oh God, this test you have given to me, I'll pass. Give me the strength to pass, fine. I don't want you to remove the question paper, remove the test. Alright? So, you'll face everything in life smiling. Your life will be full of smiles. Vandana means surrender. Those who are not surrender, you have to see their face. complain. Before they open their mouth, you know they're complaining something. Have you seen such people? If you are surrendered to God, there will be only smile in your face. Because everything happening in life is a gift from God. A difficulty, challenge, disease, everything is a gift from God. There's a God is giving to you for some reason to make you better. Will your mother trouble you for any reason? People are not saying confidently yes or no. That's not trouble actually. That's for your improvement. Right? Your father and mother are always your well-wishers. So if your father and mother are well-wishers, how can God be troubling you? Oh God, why this trouble for me? Why? As if you are a great person. So God is always graceful. Right? God is always gives everything for us, for our improvement. Even if he gives worst difficulty, that's for our improvement. If you understand this, your life will be full of smiles. If there's no smile on your face, that means that you have no surrender. Okay? Surrender means what? Whatever comes in life is a gift from God. If trouble comes in life, it's good. God is giving me a test. In school examinations, the question paper is tough. So, you curse the teacher. What kind of teacher you are? Why you are giving a tough question paper? You'll say like that? Yeah. And people say to the Lord, God, why are you giving trouble to me? As if God has no other problem. Right? So, God's purpose is not to give you trouble. God's purpose is for you to improve. Okay? The more you improve, the more tougher question paper will be.
Better not. Some people say that. Better some people say ignorance is bliss, sir. I don't want to know. I have seen a lot of people. I don't want to know all this. Why to get into so much of
ignorance ignorance is bliss, no doubt. Ignorance is mess also. There is a big mess in ignorance. If I don't know that I have a cancer, that's a bliss. Okay? But it's a mess. So ignorance is never a solution. Right? Ignorance is fine, but ignorance will lead to a messy life. So our life, we should not seek ignorance, we should learn how to drop ignorance. Then what happens? God will give you more and more and more challenges, not because He doesn't like you, but because He likes you. Because He likes you, He wants to become stronger. He wants you to become better. Right? He wants you to be better. That is the purpose. He is giving more challenges to you. Okay? And when challenges come in life, there are no problems in life. There are only challenges in life. The moment you accept as a challenge, you accept the God will be giving a boon to you. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Smaranam, Harehe, Padasevanam, Vandanam, Sakyam. Now if you start doing this, God will become your best friend. Okay? So I have a best friend. What is your best friend? What do you mean by best friend?
Who is there with you all the time.
Oh, that means, that means like a Fevicol. Fevicol friend, no.
I mean in all the situations.
All the situations, somebody is there with you. So that friend will be replaced by God. So, your friend cannot be closer to you, sitting at very close to you. But God is always there with you, all the time. And God will become your friend. Okay? Friend means any difficulty, any situation, more than your friend, God will come to your help. That's called Sakyam. Now, how does God come to your help? Oh, I have a difficulty, tomorrow I have an examination. Okay, I have not studied. Oh God. No, not like that.
You come and study.
Not like that. Not like helping. Okay? You do your job. You do your duty. So God will make sure that any obstacle comes in your duty is removed. Okay? Not that... And then any trouble is there in life, then God will come to you in the form of message of Bhagavad Gita. Okay? A message of Bhagavad Gita will come in mind. Oh, this is what you... This is the right thing to do. That's the message. God is Bhagavad Gita. So don't think that God is some person sitting somewhere. Bhagavad Gita is God. The message of Bhagavad Gita is God. Okay? So God will come in the form of message of Bhagavad Gita. Then you'll get a courage. This is what I have to do. Our President Abdul Kalam, every day morning he used to read Bhagavad Gita. Okay? So to get, because Mahatma Gandhi used to read Bhagavad Gita every day. Because see, in freedom struggle, you don't know what, see there is no solutions. Easy solutions. Vinoba Bhave used to read Bhagavad Gita every day. So there is no solution in life. See, for example, right now you are going to school and things are much more known. In a freedom struggle, when Britishers attack, when Britishers hit, what to do, we don't know. Then any time in doubt, when there is a doubt, Mahatma Gandhi used to open Bhagavad Gita, one answer will come to him. Okay? So, God will become your friend. Means, just like a friend gives a guidance and help, God will give guidance. Sakyam. Dasyam. First you will become servant. You will be servant means you understand. I am the servant of God. God will do everything through me. Okay, then you will become friend of God. Then Atmanivedanam means now God becomes God will have a permanent address, your heart. Okay? So God will be fully seated in your heart, fully seated in your mind, so that whatever you do, the God is there. You will have no doubt that God only is acting to you, acting through me. God only is talking through my tongue. God only seeing through my eyes. God only hearing through my ears. Okay? So that clarity, conviction will come. then you are no longer a human being, you have become a divine being. So that is the opportunity for us. Okay? You have studied in school. How did human being come?
From
monkeys. Okay? From monkeys we came. Right? And we live like monkeys. But there is a possibility for us to grow up from a human being to become a divine being. To realize God in our life. Okay? And that is the opportunity for human life. To live while we are alive, to realize God. To be one with God. To be blissful. To be happy. And to help others to do service. That is the greatest opportunity of human being. Okay? So that Sri Krishna says, this type of discussion you have with your friends. Friends means who are interested in Bhagavad Gita, interested in Krishna. Don't do it with those who are not interested.